Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about how engine oil systems work. And a huge thank you to Pennzoil for sponsoring this video. They've got a line of synthetic motor oils which are derived from natural gas, which we will talk a little bit more later on in this video about. Now, how do these engine oil systems work? Well, first of all, let's talk about the goal. What is the purpose of these systems? There's really three main goals you want to keep in mind. They want to reduce friction. That's so you can create more power and be more fuel efficient. You want to reduce wear, of course. That's probably the most obvious goal of having oil in here. So you want to prevent metal on metal contact by using oil in between those two metal pieces, and that will reduce wear. And then, of course, remove deposits or contaminants. And so that's just so you don't damage anything in the engine. So you want it to be efficient, you want it to last for a long time, and you don't want to damage it. So these are the goals behind using engine oil and this engine oil system. So how does the system work? Well, really there's a cycle that the whole thing follows, and it all starts in your oil pan or your engine sump. So you've got your oil all built up, just hanging out down there. You've got an oil pickup tube, which is going to suck up that oil into the pump. This pump will be driven by an engine belt typically, and so that's going to pull in that engine oil. It's going to send it through an oil filter, and then out of the oil filter it's going to be dispersed onto different channels and lubricate different systems within the engine. So one of the first ones here, the crankshaft, and so it's going to be sending oil to these journal bearings about which the crankshaft rotates. So if you're looking at a crankshaft, that would be like right here and right here, that you'd be sending that oil in these channels right here to rotate so that they would remain lubricated. And then there's going to be paths within these channels that would travel up to this connecting rod bearing here so that that can remain lubricated as well. So the oil will come in here, travel up through here into the crankshaft, and then lubricate that connecting rod bearing right there. So that's how your crankshaft is going to remain lubricated. The oil can then, of course, just fall back down into return channels and return to your oil pan. Another system we're going to send that oil to, of course, is the piston. So you could have a rail which is going to be squirting oil up underneath these pistons to keep them lubricated, to keep these skirts lubricated, and make sure you have a nice seal for combustion. And so you'll also notice on these pistons you've got these little holes on it, and what these little holes do is allow for that oil to return, to drain out and fall back down into the return channels and return to your oil pan. So we're lubricating our pistons, we're lubricating our crankshaft, and of course we have to be able to lubricate our valve train. So here you can see the different ways that we're going to lubricate this valve train. We're going to have those same similar style journal bearing lubrication like we did with the crankshaft on our camshaft where it's rotating. It'll also be spraying oil onto the cam lobes. That's where you're going to have a really high pressure when that cam lobe is opening and closing the valve. So you want to make sure that you have a good oil film right there to protect those camshafts. And so that's the lubrication of the valve train. It will eventually all drop back down and fall back into your oil pan, and then this cycle will repeat itself. Now, a couple things to note, you'll have pressure within these lines, and then once it's released, that oil pressure is gone and it falls back down into your channel. And so as you increase your engine RPM, because your pump is belt driven here, you're going to increase that oil pressure, and you want that to happen because as these components are moving faster, you need the oil to circulate through them faster. So that happens naturally because you've got that geared with your engine, and so it's going to speed up as your engine speeds up and make sure everything is lubricated. And as I mentioned, everything eventually just falls back down and goes back into your oil pan, and the cycle repeats itself. So what does all this have to do with Pennzoil? Why are we talking about synthetic oils derived from natural gas? Well, there's a couple benefits of using natural gas as their derivation for their base oil. One of the advantages is it allows you to use low viscosities at low temperatures. So these 0W20 oils, when you see that zero winter grade, that typically means it's going to be a synthetic oil because it's very difficult to get convention oils down to these low temperatures. Another advantage, or to have to have good lubrication, to have good flow, to have low viscosity at these low temperatures. Likewise, it will have a low volatility at high temperatures. So when the oil gets really hot, what this means is it's not going to be burning off the lighter molecules within that engine oil. And so that keeps its current original characteristics throughout the life of that oil, which is a really good thing to have. So with some simple conventional oils, those lighter molecules will burn off and you're going to change the grade of the oil. So at cold startups, it's going to start to get heavier, and it can even be heavier once it's at operating temperature. And so at cold startups, you're not going to have the protection that your engine was designed for towards the end of your cycle of your engine oil interval. And once you're at operating temperatures, it may not be flowing the way it was designed to. So that's one of the big advantages of using synthetic oils, is that they maintain their viscosity properties throughout that oil change interval, versus conventional oils will tend to start to get thicker towards the end, not quite retaining their original properties as well as synthetic oils. So thank you all for watching. And if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below.